We've added these controls to the form, and they're ready to be used. But if we run the application right now, currently, there is nothing connecting these controls. I'm connected to my Pi system, to my AF server, but there are no databases showing, and I don't see any elements either. So let's make those connections. In the code behind this form, either in its constructor or when it loads, we can make the connections that we need to make between the Pi system picker and the AF database picker. In other words, when someone picks a Pi system and connects to it, we can choose a database from that Pi system. Fortunately, this is about one line of code. All we have to do is set for the AF database picker, its system picker property will point to the Pi system picker object that we've got on the form. Just binds to it, watches it, and when there's a system that's selected and connected, our database menu will be populated. Let's try this out. If we run the application, there we go. We automatically connected to our default Pi system, and now I have the list of databases available for that Pi system. The final step here is if someone selects a database, I'm interested in seeing the elements from it. So for that, I'm going to stop debugging my application, and I'll go back to my form. So for the AF database picker control, we want an event handler to handle the event of someone selecting a database. Over in the events section in the properties dialog in Visual Studio, the good old selection change event handler is there waiting for us to use it. So if we just double click in this area, we will get a default event handler that we can put our code in. Double click, and now we have an event handler that's called anytime the selection of the AF database picker changes. Because we're about to be using some of these objects from the AF SDK, it's time to add some using statements up at the top. This, of course, isn't required, but it'll make our lives a lot easier. Some of the using statements that I just always add by reflex when I start coding with the AF SDK are the root AF namespace, and some of the other ones here from the AF SDK object hierarchy. I normally add the root, I'll add asset, time, and unit of measure. And that should get us started. That way, a lot of the objects that we're expecting to have direct access to, like the AF element object, well, the AF element object is actually part of this asset namespace. There are no naming collisions in the AF SDK, so just adding these references in as desired really won't cause any problems. So now we're free here. When someone picks a database, we want to see if they're is in fact a good database selected. So if database not AF database. There we go. You notice that I kind of just jumped in and found this AF database object. Now a lot of times we might have to go to the AF SDK reference to kind of figure out, okay, within my Pi system, there's this AF databases collection, and there's an AF database object. Of course, I recognize this from doing things graphically in Pi System Explorer. Most of the times, these names are very straightforward. So we have our database, and now it's time to set the root of the AF tree view to have the database's elements. Let's look at the database object. If we go back here, and we look at the AF database object, you'll notice that we have a collection of AF elements. Well, that looks like a good place to start. In other words, if I want to see a tree view of the elements in the database, I'll set the root of the tree view to be that AF elements collection. There we go. Now, one thing that we want to handle in the AF SDK is the null case. What if the selection in that AF database picker is in fact nothing? That's always a concern in the AF SDK, that our objects might be null. So rather than just handling an exception, we can code for this. By default, we clear the tree view, and then handle a good database selection if we have one. So if our database is not null, then we will use its elements as the root of the tree view. Let's see if that works. There we have it. Our control automatically found the default AF server and connected to it. We can select a database here and get its elements in this AF tree view. And all of that took just a couple of lines of code. So now we've got these controls. We've got the users able to select an AF element, and the next thing that we'll do is handle that selection and do something interesting with it. So here in our AF applet, we've got the tree view all plumbed up and working, and it's time to handle the case of a user selecting an element and doing some interesting things with it. What we'll do is when a user selects the elements, we'll allow them to select an attribute from that element and get some data for that attribute. First step here is handling the element selection and populating a list of attributes. So I'm going to add a list box to hold the attributes of the selected element. I'll call my list box here, go back to its properties, and call it LB attributes. Of course, you're welcome to use any name you prefer. I'll call mine LB attributes. Okay. So as far as a user selecting an element, let's look at the event handlers on the AF tree view. The default, in fact, event handler is the after select, which is exactly what we want. So we can double click in this combo box for the default event handler stub to be added. Double click, and there we have it. So what we're trying to do here is take the selected element, grab its attributes, and add them to the list box of attributes. So what's our selected element? Well, in the AF SDK, within every database, there's that collection of elements, so we're hoping that whatever is selected will be an AF element, and that that AF element will have some attributes. That's the idea. So some AF element is selected, which will be the AF treeview1 dot AF selection. Now the AF selection comes back as an object. So if this object happens to be an AF element, we will cast it as such. Now in the AF SDK, it is always possible that, of course, this AF selection comes back as some other object type. If we had other things in our tree view, it could be any other type of object. Using this as keyword in C#, allows the cast to fail as a null and not throw an exception if we end up getting an object that is not an AF element. If we get something that's not an AF element, our selected element will be null. So let's see. Regardless of if we have a good selected element or not, we probably want to clear that attribute list box. And then, if our element is good, then we'll add its attributes to the list box. Now you'll notice that the addRange method on the old Windows Forms list box takes an array. That's not really a problem. What we can do is we can look at our selected element, grab its attributes, which is an AF attributes object. We can just send it to an array of AF attribute. There we have it. So let's see if that works. Run this project. And now, if I come into my tree view and I select a tank, I get that collection of root level attributes in my list box. Next, we will look at handling these attributes and getting data at certain times for them.